it's Kate. I'm sick and I'm at home. I'm in my pajamas with my dinosaur blankie and my dogs, and my pineapple princess just arrived. So, yay. obviously I haven't opened her yet, so I'm going to do a little unboxing. I'm sorry if you can't hear me very well. My tonsils are all swollen and I just feel gross. So, the thing. Let's see. This is exciting. Unfortunately, my scissors aren't very good, but hopefully I'll get in to the box, and this is my first ever unboxing video. Well, I guess I did a package opening. Oh, these scissors are shit. Yeah, I did a package opening, but it's not quite the same as unboxing a whole doll. So this might take a wee while. See, when I stick my tongue out, that's my concentrate face. And now I know I shouldn't use my embroidery scissors for opening parcels, but they're already kind of munted anyway, so whatevs. I should have done this bit before I started recording, huh? Now they're stuck on my head. Oh dear. Yeah, this is basically what my life is like right now. Just calamity after calamity, but that's okay. I'll get over it. Who needs a knife when you've got sharp nails? Apparently me. So this lady shipped on,
hello,
on Friday from Japan. I only got the tracking information yesterday, and she arrived before 10 o'clock on Monday morning. So that's pretty good. I've got it directly from Junie Moon. Their prices are either the same as CC Toys or slightly better. And as you can see, they package them really well and it always arrives really fast from Junie Moon for me. So I will continue doing so. Oh yeah, the shipper! I forget about the shipper. Here, have some paper dogs. So yeah, they ship the Blythe doll in a box inside a box. I'm gonna eat that. I'm gonna take that away from you because I might use it again later. Okay. Now Louis has to investigate the paper. Oh god. Box is so funny. You guys, don't eat it. Okay. Okay. It's just about getting the first hole made. Once the first hole is made. Just in case. I'm sure she'll live with me forever, but you never know. struggle so much to get into a box before. Send Beatrice to the bishop. Look, an extra piece of cardboard. Ooh, I think I opened... No, I didn't open the wrong end. They put her in upside down. Me. It was me. I was patting the sofa. Dun, 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 dun. Oh no, she wasn't upside down. Now she's upside down. Oh, she's exciting. Oh, I'm really happy. Oh, shiny and pretty. Oh, her hair doesn't look too bad, but you know, with Blythe dolls, looks can be deceiving. So, excuse me. I'm sorry, baby. I'm prepared for to have to give her a really decent spa. That's okay. I quite like giving them a spa treatment. It's kind of a bonding experience to me. Okay, it's sad that I've deboxed so many Blythes that I'm sat here thinking, oh, they've taped this plastic sleeve down differently to how they normally do. That's kind of worrying, and I don't even have that many, but so she's number 17. Okay, I have quite a few. Why does this bit always take the longest? It's because I don't want to tear the box. She's got a little cutout. You can't really see it very well. There, you can see this little cutout to go on her stand. A lot of people don't remove them. I tend to because I think they're super cute. I decide to sell on the doll, then this is going to go back in the box with her, probably, so, you know, it's part of her, it's part of her thing. It's a really cute box, it's very summery and cheerful, which is funny because it's middle of winter here, and that's why I'm sick, although I get sick quite a lot. Balance. Do your thing. Stay there. So, I just love her little outfit. I just was absolutely smitten with her outfit when I first saw it. And I've never had a tan Blythe. But oh my god, she looked beautiful. The green eyes are kind of a little bit misty, but I wonder how much is dust. Yeah, she's... Yeah, I'm just poking her face. That makes total sense. Okay, let's get this baby out of her box. Gently remove the tape from her head. I'm not going to keep that tape. I shall snip it. Snip it good. Okay, so her head should be free. here. I just wanted to show her again. But yeah, I'm gonna find my proper cutting tools and cut her out. And so technically I'll be unboxing her off camera, but I don't think you guys will mind because she'll be free and you can see her and I'll show you all the stock. Please excuse the poor lighting. I've had to draw the curtains because it's bright sunshine coming through and it makes it really hard to see her. Her face is lovely. One set of special eye chips is really weird because it's got kind of like a translucent film. Oh, sorry, sinus. Over the pupil, like they haven't painted the pupil as dark as they might otherwise have. And I would love to show you all the eye chips, but her hair is, as you can see, just so disgusting. Like I'm trying to create a barrier between her hair and my hands by holding her by her butt. So, and she's got the crappy panties. Like they just haven't made decent panties in ages. For the Takara releases, unless they're bloomers, everyone complains about it, and it's true. It's shit. It's really disappointing. You can't really see the pink in her dress because of the. Well, you can kind of see it now. It's a very light pink. It's really really cute. Love the bodice. Just I really like this dress. I thought it was a halter neck. Sorry, touching your hair. I've got a thing about textures, and it's like oily but sticky at the same time. But it's got that cute little crossover at the back. Okay, no, I don't have to touch your hair anymore. I like her earrings, they're really cute. But yeah, she definitely needs a spa. I'm probably gonna have to do like a vinegar rinse, maybe. I have to touch it again and see. Oh, it's so gross. No, do not like. Do not like. I'd rather be touching a sheep or something, because at least it's an organic grossness. Yeah. Anyway, so. But she is very cute, and I like her. And, hi. Yeah. So. With her came, here is her stand, and it's a translucent yellow. I think it's really nice, actually. And there's this really cool little detail. I think this is probably the case with most of the stands, but you don't get to see it. But if I can get it to focus on... No, probably not, because it's looking at my face. Don't look at my face! Oh, shitballs. Oh, fuck. Yeah, it's not gonna... I'm gonna try and edit that bit out. So there's like a textured bit inside the end, and it makes me think of pineapples, so which is very appropriate for the pineapple princess. So her stand is really cute. I'm gonna put the cardboard cutout on it at some point, but not yet. Here's the sunglasses. I've not put them together yet, but they're freaking cute. God, so much strength needed for that. Ugh. Okay, I don't have a lot of strength right now, and I'm gonna stop coughing any minute. There we go. So anyway, some adorable little sunglasses. See, look, they almost work for me. Hee hee, I look like a Snapchat filter. And I don't really use Snapchat, by the way. These shoes are a lot cuter than I expected. Ooh, they go with my dressing gown. But when I saw pictures of them, I thought they were going to be a bit like nostalgic pops, and those shoes are weird. I do not like those shoes. But these are really quite, you know, they're quite cute. Yeah, they're a nice shape, and they've got a little squishiness going on. Tiny socks. Love tiny socks. Her jeans are really cute. They're, and oh my god, the pockets work. Holy shit, guys, the pockets kind of work. I mean, it's just a hole right the way through, but you can put their hands in their pockets. So, I mean, I wouldn't usually put stuff in their pockets because how are you ever going to get it back out? But there we go. But oh my god, guys, that's so exciting. And the little shirt is really cute. It's not brilliantly finished. It's okay, but I guess because of how it's gonna sit on her, it's kind of like a crop top shirt. It's cute. And her little hairband thing, which I'm not gonna put on her head until her head is less gross. So. Okay, so that's my pineapple princess. Thank you for joining my epic unboxing. It took me like 15 minutes to get her out of the box, which isn't too bad. I've had a lot of practice at gently slicing open the bits of tape around the plastic. And oh yeah, and I found my Stanley knife, so that helped. But yeah, I'm really pleased that she's here. And I think after she's had her spa and maybe I'm gonna give her a new pair of knickers because these are awful, and I think she's gonna fit in really well. It's really nice to have a tan girl, and I just love her hair. In fact, she's actually my first, well, I say my first brunette. So I know some people class Nostalgic Pop as brunette. I guess it is super, super dark brown, but I'd say her hair is more black than brown. But we can quibble over terms until the cows come home and it's not gonna make any difference. But anyway, she's my first with actual brown hair. So there you go. Thanks for joining me. I'm gonna go back to bed now. Bye.